Hi, this is Dave Zwang with What They Think. And with me is James Lee from Jones Packaging. James is the Director of Technology and Innovation up there. And one of the things that I find fascinating about Jones Packaging is you guys are probably at the forefront of a lot of the intelligent packaging. And of course, that in itself raises a whole question. So what is intelligent packaging?
So the idea of intelligent packaging, we know packaging serves a few different functions. Preserve and protect and convey information is primarily what packaging is used for. But now we're trying to find different ways that we can engage, and using digital technologies and electronics technologies, we can actually add and enhance capabilities to the package.
So with you, you brought a couple of examples.
I will raise that up. So the example I brought was actually a test carton that we created, which has an integrated NFC. So that's a near field communications chip inside. Now, when I take this phone and I tap the package.
This cold medicine product is factory sealed and genuine.
So you can see that it's actually telling us more. And now that was the sealed product. Here's the unsealed product where you can see it's been opened. And when I tap it, so it's aware of the two different states of the package. Why is that important? In the case of pharmaceuticals, we look at applications for brand protection, tamper evidence, so now we know that the package has been opened or it's still in its sealed state.
It's fascinating. Now, one of the other things that I find fascinating is that now that you have this near-field communication, you've got this NFC, there's a lot of other things you can do. I mean, you scan this, there's other intelligence, I assume.
Absolutely. So I think, you know, when you look at things like NFC technology, you're talking about a technology that is a little bit costlier than your standard package. But you got to look at it as the standpoint of, can you kill multiple birds with one stone? So with this one NFC, I'm doing brand protection and tamper evidence. I can also push marketing data. I can push information on promotions. And I can also receive things like the tap will allow me to geolocate where somebody tapped this thing and where they actually bought the product, where they've opened it. These are the types of data points we can now get.
So if that's the case, then this is happening in a store. This is in a brick and mortar store.
Yeah.
So I'm now able to, or could be able to, get the same type of information that I'm getting through an online sale or
Absolutely.
A query.
Absolutely. And another issue, I guess you'd say, is that retailers right now, they're trying to control the brand messaging. They're trying to control it by providing their own messaging. And the brand's messaging kind of gets lost. This is a technology that allows us to actually keep that messaging with the brand, and they can continue to control it in the retail shelf.
Which is probably the way it should be. I'm sure the brands are probably feeling a lot better, or would be feeling a lot better about that.
That's the idea.
Yeah. What's the adoption look like?
Well, so I would say that right now we look at NFC technology, it's already being used all over the place. And probably the biggest area where NFC technology is used actually is mobile payment. Mm-hmm. And I look at it as kind of an enabler. Once we have higher and higher adoption rates of mobile payment, people have NFC turned on their phones, then it just becomes second nature just to tap. And when that occurs, we're going to start seeing larger adoption rates. It is starting to happen now, but it's not huge at this point in time, but it's definitely something that is coming. And I think it was Cisco. Cisco Systems, I believe they said that it was about 50 billion tags they expect to see on store shelves by 2025.
One last question on this, because I could speak to you all day on this. But one last question. So, all right, so this is great. And I think that the ability to capture this data is important. What about standardization? Because we'll find ourselves in that same QR code thing. If I don't have the app for that code or...
Well, that's the beauty of NFC. So when you look at the near-field communications tech, it's already baked into Android. So when you're running a phone that's running Android 4.4 or higher, it's automatic. Mm-hmm. When I showed you this demo, I didn't have to open an app or anything like that. I can drive directly to a mobile website and have a rich mobile web app experience in that process.
Yeah. James, really appreciate it. Thank you so much for coming.
No problem.